Hi subbies, how are you doing? Today is Thursday the 25th of July and I am filming another video. Sorry, a flock of birds just went straight over the house. I'm filming my entertainment bag. I've just filmed the what's in my suitcase, so now I'm filming what's in my entertainment bag. I am in the same top. It's a clean top. I'm not gonna bother changing as I've got a lot to do and not as much to do now, but I've just got filming to do and I've got to clean my bedroom and I'm doing last minute shopping tomorrow and I need my tea as well, so yeah. But today I'm doing what's my entertainment bag. It is currently 20 past 6 in the evening and it is saying on my weather forecast there's supposed to be thunderstorms from now till 12 in the morning. Yet the sky is basically clear at my side of the house, whereas the other side of the house probably black. But I'm hoping there's a thunderstorm tonight because it is way too hot. And the worst thing is there's warnings all the way through till Sunday for Yeadon, whereas Abbasoc is all no warnings, no thunderstorms. And whilst we're there, we're getting 20 degree weather. Woohoo. Just hope it's a lot cooler. Anyway, I'm filming this. This is my intake bag. I actually don't have a lot. I don't have everything here in here at the moment, as I'm going to be obviously taking my camera, which is going into this camera. This is going in this camera case, so that is going to be in there. But I've also got chargers for my phone and my iPod. So my iPod and my phone will come in as well. I'm doing last minute shopping tomorrow, so I might end up coming on with some like colouring books, because I do like therapeutic colouring over there as well. But in the car I don't really do much. I just listen to music on the way there, and I am going to be filming as I said in my last video, but not my family. But on the way there I am travel sick, so I don't actually do any colouring or anything. I play music and I just actually watch the journey, like see what's going on, whereas I might end up going to sleep. So yeah, without further ado, let's get on with this what's in my entertainment bag video, which is very strange. Let's go. So in the front compartment right here I have some things, some essentials. I made this, like, I didn't specifically put things in places for just to easy grab, but in there I've got a body puff because this will not go into my Zoella first of the mall bag. I've also got my brush, as this actually is an essential, but like I'm just going in there because it fits. I've also got these travel sickness wristbands, as these ones, I've never actually used the pressure, these are the acupressure ones, which is like where that white bit of plastic is there, it actually pushes it onto your skin and it's like an acupressure point, and I've actually never used these before. I bought them last year and I didn't even use them last year because I didn't actually get travel sick last year, but I always take travel sickness tablets as well as last year and this year wristbands, because I prefer to not use these because these have very big side effects on me. They make me drowsy, they make me feel sick, so I try avoid these, and they do look quite crushed. That is because I bought them last year before, but the sell by date, the expiry date on them is actually 2020, so it's actually got quite, it's got a year, well less than a year. But these are sturgeon tablets and they just help with travel sickness, but I don't use them. I use them if it's a last resort, if I get like severe travel sickness I will use them, but I've not actually been travel sick this much last year or this year, so hoping not to use them, just take them in case, and then also use them if I need to as well. And then I have my full bottles of sun cream and after sun, as it is supposed to be 20 degrees, and I'm not having the stupid idea of not actually wearing sun cream last year. Last year I sat outside for a good, how long was it? It was about half an hour reading a book with a hat on, and I changed from this into my bikini, and I sat on the deck, and it was the hottest of the year last year, and I came inside, I didn't have any sun cream on, I was only outside for half an hour reading the book, came inside, and I looked like a drumstick. Yes, I've got pictures of it, but it's like not, I'm not going to put it on here, but I looked like a drumstick. Wherever I wasn't wearing clothing, I was red. Over the rest of my holiday, I had the worst time because it was just like constantly, like I had a great time, don't get me wrong, but like constantly off the plane after sun and feeling so ill. So this year, I've got myself a brand new bottle of Nivea Sun 20. This is so that I can get a tan, because my grandma tans really well, and she told me 20 SPF 20 is the best one to get for tanning. Just keep applying it and you should get a tan. But I burn instantly, so great. Like, I don't actually look burnt now because I'm not burnt. Like, I've got a slight tan, but it's coming up quite pale in here, which is great. Just lighting for you. But I've got this Nivea Sun after sun cream, and then after sun. This stuff is amazing. It's got aloe vera in it. It's so nice. It soothes up so amazing. I definitely recommend that and that. Now onto the main pouch. I actually don't have a lot, as I said, in here. I just have things like like bath stuff, shower stuff, etc. I've got all these pads because I am due and I am just taking them in case. I'm only taking one pack because we do go to Asda on Sunday, and if I do need more, I will buy them from there. And I could always go to like Abasok and end up buying some more if I don't actually come on to prepare the rest of my way. But I just take them just in case that I do start. I don't know. I just take them just in case. I've taken these water bombs with us, as me and brother and sister have a water fight in the garden, so I'm taking these and also some refills, so they're for the garden. These are mainly for Lucy for the beach, as she's looking forward so much to going and building sandcastles and digging big holes to her, and also going into the sea. So I bought these last year from Abasok, but I actually bought them like on the last week when we actually didn't go because it was too late to go down, it just wasn't the weather. And these were 50p from one of the news agents, but they're just four flags, a British, no, a UK flag, a Welsh flag, that flag, which I haven't got a clue what that one is, so please tell me in the comments below. And I'm going to try to talk a bit more slowly now because I am talking so blooming quick. And then also another one in the middle, but they were 50p, and why is this turned into a haul, I don't know. So I'm taking them for Lucy. I'm also taking these as, in Wales, sometimes we have thunderstorms or like rain, because obviously the chalet is just metal and it's not insulation. It's very loud when it rains and it sounds so much like hail. I don't like it when it's like too loud, like rain or anything. It makes me really anxious, really scared. So it sounds really bad for a 21-year-old, but like I'm sensitive to loud noises. So I'm taking these from our bargains. This is the eye mask and earplugs, and I got them in neon pink. These are hopefully gonna just help me with the sounds. I normally do like put earphones in, but this year I decided to get some earplugs and I'm hoping these work. I've also got an eye mask, which I never wear eye masks because I hate being in full black. I hate pitch black, so I'm just going to be using the earplugs in these. So I'm most likely just going to take the earplugs out and leave the eye mask at home, but I've got them for an essential for when I go away. I've also got some of these. These are for I forgot about nail and remover. I'm mostly thinking about just buying it from Abasok, from Wales, because I don't have any refill bottles for my nail varnish, and the bottle I've got is actually too big for my bag, so, as in the bag that I want to put my shower stuff in. So I've decided I'm most likely going to be just buying it from Abasok, because I am wanting it to do my nails over there. That's also what I need to put in. Oh, guys. Nail varnish. I need to put nail varnish in, earrings in. Oh wow, I've left a lot to last minute. This is so annoying. Anyway, I'm taking these just so for the micellar water and also for the nail varnish remover. Now I'm going to drink because I'm getting a headache. Which is also a sign of thunderstorms for me, because I get like headaches before thunderstorms. Also taken with the originals. These are holiday essential for me. I love these. They always remind me of holiday. So I'll take back these, and as I said, they're just a holiday essential. Also mints are as well. This year I'm actually thinking about eating in the car, like sweets or anything. I'm thinking about eating like sweets and to help with the popping of my ears, because we do go down a lot of hills and up a lot of hills, if you know what I mean. So the pressure does differ. So I'm thinking actually about eating sweets this year, which I've never been for. We'll just die actually in the car, because I never, like, once, but years ago I used to not eat in the car at lunchtime because I didn't feel well. I felt physically ill, like, because I was travel sick, I didn't want to eat at lunch in the same way home, but that made me even worse. So I've started to eat, and I'm super happy that I'm actually eating at lunchtime, so I bought them for that journey and also for when I'm actually there. Then I've taken two underwater cameras, as this could possibly be our last year going, and I actually want to take some pictures underwater and see. Please comment down below if you know what shops process disposable camera film, because I either think it's Boots or a local one up Eden. But please comment down below if you do know any shops that do process film for cheap, because I'm wanting to get this processed, because I've actually taken about 5 pictures on one of the cameras just like from this year. just so that I can have memories. But yes, I'm taking this on the day, and I'm looking forward to actually to putting them in the sea and taking pictures. Sounds cringy, but I've always wanted them the water camera, and these were dead cheap from Asda. I could just get a GoPro, but then I'm only going to use it once, so there's no point. I'm taking a word search, I got some from work, and I only wanted the little one because the one I've actually got one, but it's like a full-sized notebook. I'm also going to put my diary in, that's forgetting as well, and a pen. But I'm taking this word search. This word's actually quite expensive, £2.30, but it's mini, it'll do me, just when it's like rainy days or whatever. Great for word searches, great weather for word searches. What? I'm also taking this Jojo Moyes Still Me book. I've actually just received Louise Pentland's new book. It's coming quite dark. I think there's a big black cloud coming over, but I don't know because I can't see the other side of the house. But I've just received through the post, because I ordered it on pre-order from W. H. Smith, I've just received her Louise Pentland's new Wild Women book, and I got it signed. I'm super chuffed with it, guys. I got her signed book. I now have Zoella's signed book, Alpha Day's signed book, and also Louise Pentland's. Super, super chuffed. I am super chuffed with it. I cannot believe that she got like 3 signed books now, and I'm actually going to read hers because I've read all the other ones, but I'm super excited because I've read all of her Wild About Me, Wild About the Girl, and I forgot what the first was called, but Wild About the Girl and also Wild Women. I'm looking forward to reading the last one. But I got this last year, or was it this year? I can't remember. But I have not read Georgia Moyes in a while, and I'm wanting the follow-on book from the, from her Me Before You book. I am wanting, to read the next one, because obviously it's a movie, and I want to know what actually happens next, so here it is. And it should have lasted me the whole holiday, because it's a flipping thick book, so that's going to be great for my holiday. Then I'm taking 2 Weetabix, as this is for the Sunday morning, because we don't actually have any groceries with us. We only take essentials for the night, like lasagna, and also essentials like tea bags and stuff like that. But we don't take cereal, so she decided I'm going to get 2 of these. It's a 40p from Morrison's. I got one of these for myself, and I had the last one. But I got one of these just so that it's compact, and I actually can have a breakfast the next morning, because last year I didn't. Because we'd have any Weetabix cereal with us. And we went to Pafeli Asda around lunchtime, and oh my gosh, I spent so much rubbish. I spent so much money on junk food. Because I was shopping on an empty stomach, and it was lunchtime. I didn't have any breakfast or any lunch, and I was starving. And I was like, yes, okay, gonna buy that. And I didn't eat. I ate it, but like, I left a lot of it. Ended up giving some of my brother, my sister, my grandparents. But this year I'm taking away bakes just so that I've actually got something to eat the next morning. And then on the salad food, we've also taken this fried bean toast pie, steak kidney pie, because this is for the night time, as we have lasagna every year. It's like a tradition on the Saturday night when we go. But because I love lasagna, but my body doesn't agree with it, I decided I'm just going to take a pie with me this year instead of having lasagna. I'm also taking my Port Marion bookmark with me for the book instead of having to buy one over there. Last thing is this, which I am either going to have to turn the camera off for a couple of minutes or just whiz through this, because my camera has been in a temperature warning and I don't want it shutting off for me, because that's what happens. So I'll see you in a minute. So I've just had trouble with the camera. I finished filming that bit at 1:30 because my camera had a temperature warning. I left it 10 minutes and basically I've come back to actually turn the camera on, because that's how much it took last time. It took 10 minutes to cool down. Come back to the camera to turn it on. Waited a good 10 seconds, because sometimes it doesn't start up automatically, it doesn't start up straight away because it's got a big lens, it has to go through the functions to open the lens up. I waited 30 minutes and it just would not come on, and I was like, oh, okay, this is good. So I've basically taken the battery out, put it back in again, given it a good 20 minutes to cool down. It's now 10 to 7 and it's now working. So I'm just going to get on with this, and I'm going to, I've got one more video to film, which is going to be What's My Handbag. I might end up having to leave that till tomorrow, because I most likely am, because I'm going out tomorrow morning with my brother to go last minute shopping. So I don't actually have my handbag ready for when I'm going to holiday yet, so most likely to do that tomorrow. But yeah, great. Hopefully I don't break the camera. So the last thing I'm going to show you is the first of them all bag. I've managed to fit all of my shower stuff in here and like morning routine stuff in here. So it's crammed full. It just shuts, but I'm going to show you what I've got. So I bought a collapsible toothbrush. This one was from Asda. It was like £1.50, I don't know. But instead of taking a full-sized long one, which doesn't collapse at all, I was like, I am trying to take less this year and bring less home. So I got a collapsible toothbrush, which just collapses into itself like that. But this one's just easier to take and dispose of, as it can do that. Just the other one was full-size, guys, and it wouldn't fit into the bag. And I wanted to take as little room as possible, so that's why I've like got less in this bag. But I've got my toothbrush. I also have, I also reduced the size, the bottle of Femfresh. I didn't know the Morrison's stock travel size Femfresh, so instead of taking a full bottle, I've decided to take a mini version. And this one's only 50 ml. It'll keep me going for 2 weeks, especially if I have a shower every night. So I've taken travel size Femfresh. I'm super chuffed that I do a travel size one, as this will be easier to take with me instead of taking a full bottle. I've also got this tiny tube of toothpaste. This obviously will last me 2 weeks when I brush morning and night. So this will last me 2 weeks. I love how dinky they actually get the travel size stuff down to. It is a waste of plastic, but like it's a lot less plastic than taking a full tube with me. So I'm taking a how many mils in this? It doesn't say. 25 mil in this of toothpaste. So I'm taking that. I've also got a travel size razor, which you all know what you shave. So, well, women shave anyway. Anyway, I've got a travel size razor. I was going to take a disposable one. This one is a disposable one. But I mean like the versions which I normally use now, because they use disposable ones at home as well. But this one is just a bit smaller, and I think it was like 38p, but they've gone up to 150. So I just got, I think it's Gillette, no, it's Extreme 3 razor. I'm just taking this as it's a nice size and it's better than taking a stick one. I don't know. Then I'm taking this Calypso lip balm. This is one I got from Home Bargains. This is the 30 SPF lip balm. It has SPF in for the like sunscreen for lips, if you like. So I'm taking this as well, which I bought from Home Bargains. I've also got a small little dinky perfume bottle from Marc Jacobs Honey. And I am hoping to use a full bottle in this bottle in 2 weeks. It depends how often I use it, but I might end up putting it in my handbag, but I'm most likely not to do that. I've also got a travel sized mini format. This one is travel sized. I was going to take the other one, which is a different version of the Garnier Micellar Water. It's got ingredients added to actually help replenish your skin. But this one is a lot less than the other one. The other one is mini format, whereas this one is travel size, so this one's gonna be easy to take. And I haven't used Garnier in a while because I'm currently using the Pound Shop one, which hasn't made a difference, but it's just nice to wake up in the morning. Also taking this Hollister body spray. See, this is why I'm taking travel size stuff. I've got a full bottle of SoCal California spray over there, but Hollister have travel size £5 bottles, so I bought this one from Leeds. You've seen this before. It smells so nice and it's going to be amazing for when I wake up in the morning and if I need a refreshment during the day. And it's only 100 ml in there. Taking this dinky spray antiperspirant deodorant. Yes? I have 2 minutes, okay? I'm taking this Nivea black and white. 2 minutes! 2 minutes! Two minutes. This black and white invisible deodorant, Nivea. I do not use spray anymore. I always use roll-on because I found it helpful and it works better, but it doesn't. It stopped working, so I'm hoping it works. But it's the anti-yellow staining white matte protection. That does not happen. It does not happen. It's false, but it's dinky, so I decided to get that one. And then I got a small bottle of shampoo. This one's smaller than Head & Shoulders. This one's just Tresemme shampoo. So, yeah, I haven't used Tresemme in ages. I currently am using Garnier, mix up things, I don't know what you call it, but it's a nice but it's a nice shampoo. I've then also got the T-Zone. I couldn't find any smaller face wash than this, only a soap, so I was like, just check this. It's the T-Zone Fighting Facial Scrub. And then last thing is this bottle of body wash. See, this is what I mean, I've transferred the body wash which got from Morrison's into this dinky bottle. This stuff smells amazing. And I've also put two hair bands on, bobbles, we're gonna call them, because just in case I lose one. But like, look how short my hair is right now, it's not long at all. But got that as well. So that is all I'm taking in my entertainment bag for the moment. There will be also nail varnishes going in and other essentials I need, like my diary, other stuff. Yeah, so thank you guys for watching. To like this video, subscribe, comment below. I'll see you all next time guys with a brand new video, which will be a what's in my handbag. I now need to let my camera relax because it's been recording for a good 2 hours, so it's going to be screaming at me when I've done this, so I'm not surprised if I break it. Oopsies. But thank you for watching. I love you all. See you all next time by my video. Bye.